Hi everyone, I'd like to present my latest gearbox proof of concept. This gearbox is actually based on a 1980s toy called an Armatron, and to begin with I'll give you a quick demonstration of it in action. When I turn the motor on here, you'll see that the output is spinning in an anti-clockwise direction and it's spinning quite fast. As I move the gearbox selector, you can see that the speed slows down. When I move it again, it goes into the neutral position, so the output is stopped. In the next gear, it's now moving again, still in the slow speed, but it's actually changed direction. It's actually going in a clockwise direction now. And then when I go to the last speed, it's still going clockwise, but it's going faster. So this gearbox has five positions and four different speeds of gears. Two going clockwise, two going anti-clockwise, two going slow, two going fast. So to see how this works, let me slow it down a little bit. Now what we have is a motor here that's being run the whole time. It's running an axle that goes through the middle. Now that axle goes straight through the middle of this yellow frame, however they're not attached to each other. So if I was to put the gearbox selector back into neutral, you can see that I can move this yellow frame back and forward. It's not actually attached to that axle. However, it does want to spin with the axle. So the axle being driven by the motor is going clockwise, and therefore that frame wants to spin clockwise just due to the friction between the two. If I was to remove this gearbox selector, you can see that happening. Now I can quite easily stop it from spinning, but it does want to spin by itself. If I was to change the direction of the motor, then you can see that the frame also changes direction, and again, that's just due to the friction between the two. So let me put it back into the correct direction. And let me put in the gearbox selector again. Okay, so the gearbox selector is basically just stopping that yellow frame from spinning. Now, in this position, what we've done is we've stopped it at a certain point where this 20-tooth gear is attached to the motor. That's driving a 12-tooth gear. That drives these two 16-tooth gears. So, because there's a 20-tooth to a 12-tooth, there's a speed increase there. And that goes through to the output, causing the output to spin in a clockwise direction and spin in a fast speed. When I change the position of this gearbox selector, it allows the whole frame to spin over. And when it does that, we now engage this set of gears here. So we have a 16-tooth gear to a 16-tooth to a 16-tooth. So there's no difference in speed there. And that comes through to the output and it spins in a clockwise direction. But because the speed is just 1-to-1, it's going slower than the previous gear. So that's how we get the fast speed and the slow speed. When I move the gearbox selector again to the middle, you can see that the whole frame flips over again and it engages the neutral position. Now, the motor's still spinning, so it's still spinning the gears, but they're not engaging with anything, so the output isn't engaged, and therefore the output doesn't spin. When we move to the next gear, you can see that it flips over again, but notice this time that it's actually on an angle. So what's actually happened here is the gears are now engaged with a secondary axle down the bottom, and that axle engages with the one at the top. So we have a 16-tooth gear, a 16-tooth gear, then down the bottom there's a 16-tooth gear, and at the top there's a 16-tooth gear. So we've introduced one extra gear. What that does is it reverses the direction of the output. So now we're going slow, but we're going in an anti-clockwise direction. And when we move to the last position, it does a similar thing where it's using the faster speed, but it's got that one extra gear at the bottom, and therefore it's going in an anti-clockwise direction, and it's going faster. Now we can speed things up a little bit to see how it works a little bit better in a real-world situation. I can see that it's going quite fast now, and we can change gear just as easily as we did before. It's happy to flip over from one gear to the next. And actually, because it's running faster, it changes gear a little bit faster as well. And we can actually slide this back and forward quite quickly to get from one gear to the next. And it runs without a problem. Now, I'm changing gear at the moment using my hand. However, you could automate that with either a rack and pinion type setup or with a linear actuator or any other mechanism that you like to automate it. Now, unfortunately, there are a few weaknesses with this design. One is that it's quite large, and then the other is that at the moment, the way that it's set up, this yellow frame here, it has a little bit of flexibility in it, and when you actually put a load on the output, it can cause the gears to jump a little bit. So to give you a demonstration of that, I'll turn the motor back on and just put a little bit of load on it, and you can hear those gears jumping a little bit. Now, within the Armatron toy from the 1980s, there are actually six of these gearboxes involved. And they actually controlled six different functions, but they were all driven by one motor. Now, I've got some links in the description of the video if you want to learn a little bit more about the inner workings of the Armatron toy. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. And thank you for watching.